Giants, it's me, Miss Booksy. Today we have a special treat. Sometimes it's nice to go back to your favorite stories, and one of my all-time favorites is Cinderella. Coming soon, I have a longer version of the story in 8 parts. But right now, we have the original parts 1 and 2 coming up for you. Here we go. Once upon a time, there was a girl named Cindy. Here we go. So as I was saying, my name is Cindy, kind of like Cinderella, which is what my not so nice stepmother and stepsisters call me. I had to go live with them in a dark, cold place called Europe, where they have castles and princes and stuff like that. But I'm getting ahead of myself. They're always making me do all the chores. Like, it's normal for kids to help out with the dishes, feed the dog, clean her room, and stuff. But they made me do everything. All day long, I'm cleaning toilets, tying their hair bows, ironing their socks. Well, seriously, who needs their socks ironed? My only solace was my cat Fryball. And since my stepsisters were allergic, I had to keep them outside. And it can get wicked cold in Europe. One day, an invitation arrived. The prince was having a grand ball and everyone was invited. I finally had something to be happy about. Fryball and I did a little dance. But my evil stepmother told me there was no way I could go.
You have to clean the bathroom floor that night. Duh, it's Friday.
She was right. Friday was tub and toilet night. Friday came and my lousy stepsisters put on their lousy new dresses and strutted out to the ball while I got out my scrub bucket and brush and got to cleaning. I'm gonna be honest, I cried. But just a little.
Don't be sad.
Cheer up.
Thanks, kids.
Look, a fairy!
She said,
"Don't be scared. I'm your fairy godmother."
I didn't know I had a fairy godmother.
Oh, okay, so that explains why you never call, a visit, send me an email, edible bouquet. Now stop your crying. Let's get you to the ball.
Well, I don't know if you noticed, but I'm kind of cleaning the bathroom. It's tub and toilet night, and I don't have a dress.
Oh, please, stand still. Wow, pretty. Now, you'll find your limo outside. I did a little wand action on an old jack-o'-lantern for that one, and Fryball is your chauffeur. Now off you go. Oh, wait, one thing. You gotta get home by midnight. That is so important. I can't stress the importance here. There's always a catch with these spells.
And just like that, I was on my way to the ball. Woo! It was the most fun party ever. Snacks galore. They had a chocolate fountain, an 8-foot meatball sub, awesome music, a conga line, a wee karaoke foosball. It was magical. I met the coolest guy in the world. We played bowling on Wii. We ate nachos. And we realized we had the same taste in like everything. We like the same color.
Red.
The same food.
Cheese doodles.
The same movies.
But the best one is Toy Story 3.
Jinx, you owe me a Coke. Even the same taste in shoes.
Sneakers to a ball?
It's midnight, y'all!
Eek! I didn't have time for goodbyes! I made a run for it!
Bye!
I forgot to ask her name. Oh, I always get something wrong.
By the time I got back to my limo, it had turned back into a jack-o'-lantern! And Fryball back into a regular cat! I was back into my regular clothes! And somehow, I had ran right out of one of my sneakers. With one shoe and Fryball by my side, I walked home. The next day, there was a breaking news announcement from the prince. that he had met a great girl at the ball who would make a great princess. But he didn't know who she was.
I must find her. All I have is this... this shoe. And I will canvass the land and find the foot that fits this sneaker. I really think she might be the coolest girl in the whole world.
Say what? I was hanging out with the prince? Whoa, this was an interesting turn. My stepsisters argued over which one of them it was.
Oh, he loves me.
It was great. Little did they know, it was me. But when the prince and his prince people came round to do the test fitting, my stepmom sent me out back to wash the windows. I watched as my stepsisters both tried to squeeze their big feet into my shoe. Then he saw me.
Hey, what about her?
Please, will you try on this shoe?
Yay!
It's you!
And that's when my stepmother and stepsister screamed and passed out. They didn't handle shock very well.
I'm Ron Charming.
Hi, I'm Cindy.
You owe me a Coke.
Jinx!
Now you owe me another Coke.
Jinx! Now you owe me another Coke. Jinx!
That went on for quite a while. And then we lived pretty darn happily ever after from that day on. It was a real Cinderella story. And that's the end. But remember, tell us in the comments if you're excited for a new, longer Cinderella and what other series you want to see next. Make sure you click here to see the latest Wizard of Oz and all my other favorite stories. Okay, see you soon. Bye.